Welcome back to the shop. This is Randy. Today I'm going to be starting on the surface grinder wheel balancer. I got some pieces of aluminum here. Three pieces of it's 4 inches wide, 3/8 of an inch thick, and it's 7 inches long. And what I did is I put them in the mill, squared the ends and the sides. Then I took my fly cutter and I just fly cut the surface of them. And my plan is, this is going to be the bottom. I'm going to take some 1032 screws and drill from the bottom. They'll be recessed in the bottom so the heads will be flush. I'm going to take 4 screws on each side to bolt the sides on, like this here. The sides are going to sit on here like this. Just like that. And then these 1/8 inch carbide rods are going to lay in a groove in the top. Like that. Let me pull this out of here so you can see a little better. These are going to lay in the top. Like such. And I'm going to take a couple of these little pins. I'm going to put a pin in each end. That way the wheel can't fall off the balancer. I've got to get this over to the mill. And the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to drill the holes to put 4 screws in on the bottom on each side. Drill them and countersink them. Then I have to drill the drill and thread 4 holes in the ends of each side, and this will bolt together like this here. So let's head on over to the mill and we'll get started. All right, first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to find the edges and go to my center.
Thank you.
Okay. All right, there's the center, and now I got to go to the edge here, so go to incremental, and I got to come over. That's zero here, that's, and then I gotta come in 100. Okay, so now my spindle's directly over the edge, and I got to divide 3/8 or 375 by 2. Okay, I came in 187 and a half from this edge, and that's where my holes are going to be. Okay, I offset to the right here 650 thousandths. That's the position of my first hole. And the next hole is going to get spaced 1 inch 300. Okay, now we got to come over 1 inch 300. That's 1 inch 950 total from center. I'm gonna finish drilling the rest of these holes off camera, and we'll come back for the countersinking. On the last hole to drill here, perfect. Okay, I'm gonna finish the rest of these off camera and we'll be back. All right, this part is all done. Now what I gotta do is set the other pieces up in the mill here to drill and tap the holes. Now I gotta start drilling the holes in the edge here for where these pieces are gonna bolt to the base. So I moved over 650 thousandths from center. Drill these holes 1 inch deep. Okay, I'm gonna finish the rest of these off camera, bring it back when I'm ready to tap them. All right, gonna start tapping this now. A little bit of tap magic here on this tap, and we'll run it in. Finish that hole by hand here. Maybe I think I'll just run it back in there again, and I'll stop the mill here. Let me go grab a tap wrench. All right, that one's all done. I'm gonna do one more for you, then I'm gonna finish the rest of them off camera. I think that other tap was a little dull. This one's cutting good. Right there. All right, all my holes are done. Screw this in here. Just like that. Okay. Now I'm gonna flip this part over, and I've got a, I believe I have an 1/8 inch ball mill. I'm gonna mill a groove across the top of it for that recess for the 1/8 inch carbide rod. I gotta look, see if I got that end mill. All right, I got a slight change of plan here. I didn't have an 1/8 inch ball and end mill, so I'm gonna use this carbide tool here. I'm just gonna make a V groove along the top here. that worked out rather well. I think. And then our little rod is going to lay right in that groove there. And I just drill a hole in the end here for these pins. And that'll keep this rod from, or the wheel from rolling off the balancing stand. So I'm going to drill that hole for those pins. Next. Let's see here. Make sure you can see. I'm going to drill a hole here, 1/4 inch deep. That. And then our little pin here should just drop right down in there, just like that. This rod will be placed on top. And that's going to be my stop. Just like that. Be one on each end, and that way that the wheel, when I'm bouncing the stone, the grinding wheel, it won't roll off. It'll hit this and stop. All right, now I got the base plate back in here, and what I got to do is I got to drill a little hole for a ball on one side and 2 adjustment screws to level it with. Drill's a little big. I got a 1/4 inch drill, but it's a little big. Yeah, I went to the next smallest drill, and I just drilled this a little bit. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to epoxy it in place. And now I got to drill 2 holes for 1/4-20 adjusting screws in the corners. Two holes are going to get drilled, one here and one here on this end, and I'm going to tap it for 1/4-20, and I'm going to make some adjusting screws, and then this part will basically be complete except for putting it together and epoxying those rods in place, this ball, and the four pins. Quarter 20 tap here. All right, slow this down here. Okay, move over here. Go 2 inches, 800 thousandths from center. Right there. Tap that hole. Okay, now I'll flip, take this part out, put the chamfering tool in, and take that edge off the top. Alright, now I'll stick part of this together here. Some longer screws here. See what this is going to look like. Those screws are in like that. Excuse me. This is going to sit on here. Switched around. There we go. One is just a tick shorter than the other. Just like that. Then this is going to be for the arbor, and it's going to roll. It's going to roll across the top just like that. Roll across the top just like that. This is what I'm going to... I got to bore this out for putting this on to hold the wheel with. And I gotta make these adjusting screws yet. But I think it's gonna work. It should. I've seen some where they've got like a knife edge blade on the top that you could buy, but I don't know if that's, I think this would be better. I mean, there's like zero friction here. So, all right, guys, now I'm gonna be making the two adjusting screws for the balancing fixture. $497. All right, I'm going to take and turn down 3/4 of an inch here to 1/4 inch, and then we're going to thread it. Size here should be at 275. Four thou under. All right. See what we got here now.
Half thou under. That's good. Okay, I'm going to chamfer this edge here. And then I'm just going to grab a threading die and thread it. Okay, cutting oil in here. Blow these chips out. Hi, Harley. And if you want to thread right up to the shoulder, what you do is you turn your die around and you start this back on there. Then you can thread right up to the shoulder. Like that. Okay, now I'm going to knurl it, and this part, this one will be done. Okie dokie, here we go.
looks pretty good. Now we're going to park this off. Speed this up. I want to chamfer that top edge here. This tip good. Almost forgot about that. Now we can finish parting it off. Finish the other one off camera, and then I'll see you back at the bench. Well, there you have it. It's all done. I've got the leveling screws. There's one right there and one right here, and then I got the ball bearing mounted in the base there. So it's actually standing on three points when you level it. It should work good. Well, there you have it. The leveling stand is all done. Now the next thing I'm gonna work on is the arbor for it. Just for curiosity's sake, I went on eBay and looked for some used ones, and they range anywhere from, I don't know, $400 to $800 for a used one, depending on what brand you buy and all that kind of stuff. But for what I got invested in this, just doesn't pay to go out and buy a used one when you can make it yourself. and for what I'm going to do, it's going to work just as good. Being it's 4 inches tall, why, a 7-inch wheel fit in there just fine. So the next thing on the list is going to be building the arbor for this, and then going to be working on balancing that wheel that I have. So hope you enjoyed that and maybe got a little something out of it. If you want to build one yourself, now you kind of got an idea how to do it. And this is the fly cutter that I made about 2 years ago. This is what I fly cut I use that to fly cut the surfaces on those. The aluminum was okay, just the way it came, but I figured, you know, if I could smooth the finish a little bit, it might make it look a little better. You didn't have to. I didn't have to go through all that. I mean, it took me a half hour to fly cut all three pieces. So, not a big deal. So anyway, hope everybody's having a great day, and we'll see you in the next one. Take care. Bye-bye.